Hi, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. In this video, I'll quickly show you how you create annotations from your data source and display them on your dashboards. By the end of this tutorial, you should have an annotation query added into your panel that can be visualized as markers across your dashboard. As a prerequisite, make sure that you already have a panel added into your dashboard, and it would be best if you have some data sources configured. For this demo, I have configured Loki and Prometheus for my data sources. Now, let's get started. So here I have a panel called Traffic that visualizes the incoming traffic from this demo application called Grafana News. So Grafana News basically just lets you post links and then you can vote for the ones that you like. Now, a user can actually add a new entry without providing any URL, and this can trigger this empty URL error in the application. So what if I want to visualize this error as an annotation to my dashboard? The good news is this can easily be configured with Grafana using annotation queries. To set this up, let's click Dashboard Settings and we'll go to Annotations. Once you're in this view, click the Add Annotation Query button. Let's give a name for our annotation query. So I'm going to call mine Errors, and I'm going to select the data source for the annotation query, which for my example, my logs are stored in Loki, so I'm going to select Loki. Now, make sure that the enable checkbox is ticked as well, because this will enable the annotation query to be issued on every dashboard refresh. So now you can choose which panel you would like the annotation query to be added. For this example, I'm going to select the traffic panel. Next, I'm going to provide the query for displaying the error logs. Now, this query will look different depending on your use case, but for this example, I'm going to check that the TNS app log file name consists of the string error. Now let's go ahead and save the changes to our dashboard. Now when you navigate back to your dashboard, you should now see a toggle button for the annotation query, and it's set to enabled by default. To test the changes, I'm going to go back to the Grafana News application and I'm going to add a new entry without any link. Now, if I go back to my dashboard, I should now see an annotation here which is visualized as a red vertical line, and if I hover over the line, I can see the error message coming from my logs. And there you have it. In this quick tutorial, I've shown you how you can add an annotation query to your Grafana dashboards. Let us know in the comment section below if you found this tutorial useful, and happy visualizing!